shepherds, and he took him by the right hand and lifted him. They were not talking to God. They were talking to him. Some of us are so deep, we think everything got to be so spiritual. There comes a time once you've already prayed, you get power. And you don't take and begin to pray about something you've already prayed about. If you say you feel the Holy Ghost and you got power in your mouth, open up your mouth and begin to command some stuff. Hallelujah. Sometimes the situation is so devastating, you don't have time to go to your secret closet. You better put out your weapon in your mouth and pray. Yes. All right.
Thank you, Jesus.
He took him by the hand and they lifted him up. And the Bible says immediately. Somebody shout immediately.
Immediately.
I say shout immediately.
Immediately.
And immediately he believed he got strength to his bones. His ankles got strengthened. His tibia got strengthened.
Yes.
The calluses on his feet dropped off. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He got strength in his body. Hallelujah. His backbone straight up. You hear that? And praising God, he went into the temple. And everybody saw him praising God. It's important that your family see you praising God. I do not believe in children's church. I think it's important that your children watch you praise God. Let me tell you why it's important that your children watch you praise God. Because if they can watch you do everything else.
Yes.
Come on, y'all sit down. I told y'all to sit down.
Listen.
It says at the 9th verse, and the 10th verse, and they knew that it was he which had sat at the gate beautiful, begging for alms. The 11th verse. And as the lame man came in, they were all amazed. They were all amazed. They just came out of an access spirit, but yet they go back into prayer. When you read the Bible, it says a certain man, it means a man that is specifically called out. That could be a certain gender. That could be a certain character. It can be a fat man, a skinny man, a white man, a black man. But we know it's a certain man. What kind of man is it?
A certain man.
Verse 5 and 6 says, and he noticed them. He noticed that Peter and John was coming, and he expected them to do the same thing that everybody else had did. Tell somebody it's not that easy.
Not that easy.
Some people expect when they come to the house of God certain things. I wanted the door to be open today because this is a servant for the masses.
Yes,
number one, I want you to understand here. People expect to see certain things in the church when they come. Because of the stuff that they have heard people say. What do they expect? Number one, some people expect every preacher to speak with everybody in the church. I'm preaching. Some people expect all church folk to be saved.
That's right.
Somebody expects all men are just dogs. They're just dogs. Somebody say that all women are simply gold diggers. But verse 6 goes on to tell us something different. But before we get verse 6, look at somebody and say, oh, but I come to beg to differ. Tell somebody, I came to make the difference. Tell somebody, I'm neither a gold digger nor am I saved. So you sit next to the real people. Say, I believe I've done everything. And I'm going to get it. Verse 6 tells me, it says that Peter and Jan and them said, silver and gold have I known. None. I don't have any silver. Have no gold. I have nothing monetarily to give to you. But in the name of Jesus, I command you to walk. I have nothing to give you. But in the name of Jesus, I command you to get up and walk. They were not talking to God. They were talking to
Him.
It's imperative that we do that. It's imperative that we understand the cause. We see what we do injustice to our people in our churches, pastors and bishops. And they tell people, if you pray about it, it's going to completely change.
Right.
No. The situation is, if you pray about it, then you have to change to fit the situation.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Can I push you up here? But see, some people, they have something already. They want to come here, they want to pass the burden and lay hands on me.
Yes.
They want to put all the blame on me.
Yes! Yes!
No, when you come up and you stand in front of me, I put my hands on you and say, God, change everything in them.
Yes.
Let their wrong become right.
Yes.
Let their downs become ups.
Yes.
I change you so you can fit the situation.
Yes.
I change you so you can deal with it. I change you so you can go with it. I change you so you can see yourself.
Yes. Go ahead.
So my prayer is, God, change them. Y'all sit down. Sit down.
Jesus.
Tell somebody, prayer changes them. But prayer changes you to handle. For you to handle what? It changes you so you can receive or modify that request out of your situation. I know somebody gonna feel sorry for me.
Mm.
I had a baby out of wedlock.
Mm.
My daddy raped me.
Mm.
Arms in one.
Come on,
I was at that church and they treated me so bad. I got hooked on drugs when I was only 10. Arms in one.
Mm.
Why are you so busy focusing on your situation? You bump into people. You bump into some Peters and some Johns who understand the real power of prayer.
Uh-huh.
And they understand that I'm not praying for you so that you can tell your story then.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I'm praying for you that you get so so lifted in Jesus that your story begins to come a step.
Yeah.
That you step up over that whole picture.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, prayer changes them. They were talking to God. They were talking to Him. They were not talking to God. After you have prayed about a situation, it's then time for you to pronounce it.
That's it.
Hallelujah. After you have laid before the Lord, it's time for you to then get up and open your mouth and look for some results behind what you prayed for. This man, number one, he was born with a struggle.
Yes.
Come on, somebody should write that down. He was born with a struggle. So you have been lying and blame shifting for years, saying, I'm like this because of my mom.
Yeah.
We're going to deal with some good stuff today.
Yes.
I'm like this because of my brothers. I'm like this because they teased me. I'm like this because of what my daddy did to me. But I come to let you know, he was a man that was born with his struggle.
Yeah.
He was born with his limbs contracted.
Yes.
Medical terms. He was born in a fetal
position.
Position.
Yes.
But yet he was a grown man. Isn't that sad? Many of us have never moved from the crib.
Yes.